First what? Welcome back to the first podcast that we've done in 2018. This is podcast number...
Fuck, what number is this one, actually?
13.
You might be close. 16. 13. This is episode 16. Welcome back, guys.
Is it 16?
Yeah. 15 right there, and we haven't done one since then.
See, that's why all those pieces...
Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, we haven't uploaded since the D&D and B&D podcast.
I don't even remember what that one was about. But...
So, I'm going to start with something. I played my first round of D&D over the weekend. That was cool. I made a new character. I'm a polar bear. And it was just me and one other guy and then the DM. And we just did a little dungeon. It was interesting doing like only two people. I didn't know. I've only ever heard of it being in a group, so it was strange to me.
You can even do one person.
Yeah. I'm guessing you and Nick used to do that.
How we'd build the stories.
Okay.
That's how most of my character got developed, because I'd think out a story, and Nick's like, so you want to play through it so we can kind of plot it out more?
Okay.
So it's just like, yeah, that's how it came to be.
Yeah, so we were actually playing, like... Basically, what we played was mine and my friend Jeremiah's. Like, it was pretty much how their meeting, like, our characters met. Mm-hmm. And it was so. It was fun. We got through the dungeon, split the loot, and then Jeremiah was like, I'm fucking tired, dude. I'm going to bed, so. Next installment will be next week where it's just us. Cool. Yeah, well, you don't need the headphones, actually. You're right. It's just a habit when we're sitting at the computer. But other than that, so that was just a little thing, because that reminded me of it, seeing the old podcast episode. I went to a furry convention last weekend called Texas Furry Fiesta, with a bunch of our friends that everybody knows. We had some J-Thor, a little bit of Trixie, we had Dewey.
Speaking of Trixie.
Do you want to tell your story first?
Huh?
Because I can go...
It's like, not a story. It's... Well, it might expand into one, but... It's just, like, what happened to him. How, like... I think it was yesterday. He said he just paid off his truck.
And then come today...
I had a dream that something happened to his truck before I saw that.
Oh, no.
I had a dream that he got into an accident with it.
Oh.
And then I woke up and saw that. I was like, I did this to him.
Well, didn't it just get towed today?
Yeah, it just got towed, but it was just like... This is my fault.
Yeah, that's fucked up. Like, he has bad luck with that truck. Like, he's like, that thing, like, tires pop all the time on him on that truck. He just now finished paying it off, and then he got towed the next day. Fucking just bad luck Trixie, you know what I mean? But anyways, so I've got quite a few stories from Furry Fiesta, because it was fucking fun. So I went out on Thursday. J-Thor paid for my room. That's the only reason I stayed there. Or else I probably wouldn't have even gone this year. So I went, you know, showed up. We had some fun. I'm trying to think of what the first story would have been. So... First good story would have been... Huh. I don't know. I'll just remember stories as I go. But one thing that happened was hanging out with my friend Musket. We were up in the pool area. We were playing pool over by the bar. And these two people walk in, or three people, sorry, walk in and sit down and start having their dinner in the pool area. And at first, we're just like, all right, let's play a couple more games and we'll leave so we don't distract, or so we don't interrupt these people. Because at first glance, they looked like they were nicely dressed and it only looked like one of those people were from the con. It looked like the other two, like, met someone from the con and wanted to talk about what the fuck the con was about. So we didn't want to mess with them at first. Then after a while, they said something and I made a joke. And then we all just started talking. A little while later, the man that was there, Jeremiah, got up and was like, hey, I'm going to play pool. So I'm like, all right, you can take my spot playing against Musket. I'll go sit down. So I sit next to his fiance, and immediately his fiance is like, you're my new fiance. He's been replaced. And so immediately I was like, no, these are cool people. So we keep playing pool. Eventually... The two girls that was with him left to go do something else. I think they went to the rave. And it was just myself, Musket, and Jeremiah. So we're playing pool. you know, we all fucking sucked at pool, so we were doing a bunch of stuff. There was one game where I was playing Musket, and Jeremiah was sitting down. Musket had just broke the balls, and my cue was, like, fucking middle of the table. He was like, I didn't sink any balls, so just literally hit anything. So me not paying attention, I just went, all right, I'll aim for anything. So I walk over real quick, and I just hit the cue. I fucking bounce the ball over a ball. It bounces again over another ball, then bounces off the table, fucking rolls away. And I'm so pissed off at myself, I say out loud, I could have hit anything, and I hit literally nothing. And for some reason, Musket and Jeremiah took that as the funniest thing in the fucking world, and they both fell to the ground laughing. So, being still angry from fucking up so bad, I start very calmly and quietly flipping everything in the room. Like, I flipped up the tables upside down, I flipped the chairs, everything was on the ground except for the table that Jeremiah was, you know, had his stuff sitting on. And then, like, I had just finished putting down the last chair, and cue his fiance walking in. What the fuck happened in here? And then I start losing it because, like, I had just said, it's a good thing nobody's walking in here. And that happened. So I had to explain to her what happened, and I had to pick it all up. And she was yelling at me, like, why the fuck are you gonna deface this nice place? And I was like, no. I was doing it calmly. I promise. Like, I wasn't gonna break anything. So that was fun.
So it's kind of like that time that you, me, and Lori kept putt-putting or whatever the hell it was.
Yes.
And then Clayton walked in.
Yeah, and then Clayton walked in. That's the most Bucky and Donut thing I have ever seen. We actually talked about that story. Or I talked about that story over the weekend, too, at that convention.
It's one of the best things I've ever had.
Oh, yeah, no, it's fucking great. Also, I vaped for the first time while I was there. Because I had put on a friend's beanie, and then I looked at myself in it, and I look like a fucking hipster. Let me see your vape. So I took his vape, and I'm like, I'm a hipster. And I actually breathed, and I was like, oh, fuck. So that was funny.
You are a hipster.
You're a hipster. Go fuck yourself.
If I were a hipster, then I'd at least have style.
What else happened at that convention? I won a couple pictures of butts. That was pretty nice. Some hand-drawn butts. Pre-framed. That was nice. I actually outbid a motherfucker who's being an asshole about it. So it was like a silent auction thing where you just come write your number and write your amount. And it was about to end in like a minute. So I'm like, all right, I'm going to count down. And it's like 2 seconds before I'm going to write my bid down. So I'm like, all right, go. And I bend down to write down my bid. And then right as I'm starting to write, I can hear the people like that are working the auction thing. And they go, all right, no more bids. And I was finishing writing my thing. And then some guy behind me that was friends with the guy that I was bidding against, just at the top of his lungs, starts shouting, hold on, let me get a little away from the mic so I don't fucking pop everything. He starts shouting, sir, put your pen down. That's invalid. You cannot, no, stop, sir. You're cheating, sir, please. And I'm just, so to get him to shut up, I just kind of scratch it out. And I look at it and I'm like, okay, I'm done. I scratch it out, please shut up. And I just start to walk away, but Musket fucking went off on him. Oh, it was the funniest thing. So, I, being, you know, kind of adult and not making a scene.
That's rare for you.
Because I wanted to win it. So I knew if I made a scene, I would not get the chance to win it. So I waited for everyone to leave the room, and I went up to one of the people that were, like, behind the table working in the room. And I went, look, and I explained the situation, and she was like, you should have kept writing down your bid. You shouldn't have let him do anything. And then someone else came over, and they were like, was he an older gentleman wearing a white shirt? And I was like, no, but I think it was his friend. He just goes, we've been having problems with them all day. Come on, we'll let you rewrite your bid. So fuck that guy. Fucking asshole. I won it anyways. Fuck you, bitch. So that's actually the butt. Specifically, it was the one that I kept. The smaller frame. Yeah. So, that was fun. Fuck that guy. Being an asshole, fucking making a scene in a fucking silent auction. Fucking asshole. Sorry. That did piss me off that night, so it was...
You mean a not so silent?
Oh episode. Yeah. I also won Trixie a little pixelated fucking Jolteon.
Yeah, saw that too.
Yeah, that was a triplet, like a triple threat thing of myself, Ross, and Cam all getting it for him. Cam pitched in the most money. I put my auction number on it and then went and picked it up, and then Ross threw in a couple bucks on it. So. Basically telling you all these stories because I haven't seen you yet, so. Like, they get to listen, but it's all for you. We also, me and a couple friends, these were all new people that I met that weekend in the hotel room, because it was the people we were rooming with. We all decided Saturday morning to get up and go to this place called the Pecan Lodge in Dallas. It's a barbecue place. Normally the line is super long. You gotta wait forever. So we get there an hour before it opens. My dumbass self forgot to take a jacket with me. It was about 30 degrees that morning. So we're standing there for a whole hour at the front of the line. First, like, 40 minutes of waiting, there was no one there. So we're like, were we fucking idiots getting here this early? And then, like, some more time passes. It's 2 minutes before it opens. The line is around the fucking block. So we were like, yeah, no, we fucking did a good thing getting here so early. Then the door's open. We walk in, and the guy points to one way. So we go that way. Turns out he pointed us to the wrong fucking lane, and we lost our spot in the line. So instead, we were like, no, fuck this. That employee of yours is an asshole. We're going to order here, even though we're not supposed to. They were like, yeah, no, he's sorry. So fucking good-ass food, dude. Like, it was some of the best barbecue I've had.
I'm glad you restated what it was, because I completely, like, spaced on whatever the hell it was called.
Pecan Lodge. I didn't say what kind of food it was. But no, it was some good-ass barbecue, man. I got, fuck, what did I get?
Food.
Yes, food. No, I think I had a sandwich. I had a pulled pork sandwich.
Ew.
Pretty good. Pretty damn
good. I used to like that before I stopped liking meat.
And then, like, we got done eating, we got our fucking stuff to go, and I call us an Uber, because I was the designated Uber guy normally at conventions, because I use the app so often. And our like, it says, your ride is completing another ride. And I just assumed, oh, I think my phone just didn't load yet, that's our car right there. So the five of us that were there all walked over, and one of the guys, Niall, who's a taller guy, pretty lanky, just goes, like, he's walking the fastest, and he just goes and he yanks open the door of the minivan. The last riders were still in the car. And all we saw from, like probably 10 feet back is the person inside the Uber going with his hands straight up, like when you point a gun at somebody. Like, his hands are in there, and he's like, ah! Ah! And he's looking around frantically, and we all just start laughing at Niall for being a fucking idiot and not waiting and looking. So, you know, thankfully, that was the place that those people were going, so they got out and we got in. And then we were talking to the Uber guy. It turns out he just picked them straight from the airport. They were straight tourists. They were tourists that had never been to Dallas.
Two before. Very different words.
Very big different words. They were tourists that had never been to Dallas, and their first, like, interaction with someone from Texas was them yanking the door open thinking they were about to get mugged. That's fucking funny to me. I hope their day got
I hope you know what
that.
The difference between a terrorist and a tourist is.
I do! My brain just slipped up the words because I was thinking of the next part of the story without
knowing what I was saying. Terrorist is one of those dudes that run around with an AK shooting people.
Whereas a tourist
is a person that goes out and buys the AK and takes it home.
To shoot people. At least here in Texas, you know what I mean? We got the guns. Woo! Yeah. Anyway,
I feel like if Chris was listening, Chris just like, no! What are you talking about?
Fuck you, Donut! And then if J-Thor's listening, he's saying, fuck you, Bucky, but for no particular reason.
No, he still says fuck you to me, apparently.
Fuck you. Nobody loves you. Oh, God, there's so many good stories from the weekend, but I'm trying to remember each one in the moment, so talk about something while I remember one.
I told you I don't have anything.
Make something up.
I don't have anything to make up.
Make something up.
I don't make up things.
Tell me about your fucking Last night's dream. What'd you dream about?
I don't remember.
Man, we were so prepared for podcasts always. I should have, like, told you to wait and let me write down all the stories or something, or bullet points, fucking something. Because this is just, there's nothing to talk about. I'm trying to think of something.
I mean, the day that we did laundry, didn't have any clothes left, so I was wearing underwear that was too tight and shorts that were too big. So my shorts were falling down, and my underwear felt like somebody was just constantly, like, pressing on my nuts.
Isn't that how you should have your nuts?
But it felt, like, super uncomfortable, because it's just, like, one way, it's just, like, alright, this is uncomfortable, because I'm trying to keep constantly pulling my shorts up, but the other way, it's just, like, oh my god, if
release my nuts.
Yeah. And my dad, at one point, was just like, why don't you just take your underwear off? I was just like, if I do that, then there's a chance that my pants are just going to fall down. Everybody's going to see everything. And then, boom, public indecency.
Nice.
So I was just like, yeah, I'd rather just deal with this.
Nice.
Yeah, that was one of my issues over the past week. I also got a stress rash all down my neck and my back and...
Pussy and
crack?
Sucked. Stress from just like the graduating stuff, or do you really know?
Not really. I'm assuming it's from like graduating, looking over all my stuff, thinking about what's next, all this stuff about like getting up and actually doing things, and it's a mixture of like physical and mental stress.
Yeah, because you have been doing a lot more physical stuff recently.
Yeah.
That's good. Also, I have been hanging out with Jeremiah and his fiance a lot since the convention already. Like, I think I hung out with Jeremiah like the next or 2 days after the convention.
I mean, it seemed like you've been with them all week.
No, I was at home because I had to babysit my nephews.
I was just like, it's better he's there than here.
Yeah,
so.
Go fuck yourself. You know you love me. They want to meet you because, like, first thing we talked about was B&D, and they were like...
Everybody wants to meet me when you start talking about me for some reason.
That's because I talk highly of you.
And I'm just
like you don't believe it, but I fucking love you, man. You're my best friend.
I'm just like, I don't know why you people want to meet me. I'm a very, like, quiet and boring person.
Yeah, but... Well, it's probably because they expect you to be like me, but you're the exact opposite of me. So it's still refreshing.
I mean, I'm good at talking, but you have to, like, get me going.
That's true.
If it's just like, all right, Thomas, you're going to be in this room at this table with this person, it's like, shit. I don't know them.
What if it's like, Thomas, here's a couple people you know, here's a couple people you don't. Just chill until you jump in.
And I start talking to them, get pushed out of the conversation, start talking to them again, pushed out of the conversation. Hey, new person, your face is weird. Shit.
And that's how you became friends with Sean.
Speaking of Sean,
I have to tell you about what happened. Fuck, I don't know if I should say it on the podcast.
Is that what caused the whole like YouTube video thing he made?
I haven't seen anything about his YouTube. We might have to cut some of this out, actually.
Don't say it unless like this is something that was...
Does it have to do with his cast?
Cast?
He must have just got his cast off then. Why don't you just type in his... Oh, look, my controllers. Yay.
Fuck, it was like right here.
I got the Splatoon.
My body hurts. What's his name? Steel Cords?
I was trying to not say that on the podcast, but yeah. Because he's a loser.
It was this. Don't play.
Don't. YouTube, don't do this to us.
Don't play it. This.
I have no idea. I haven't seen this yet.
Read the description. It was just something that he's just like felt that he had to do.
Oh yeah, no, that's probably part of it because he told me I could talk about it, but I don't know
how much.
Yeah, because it's okay. I'm just gonna talk about it, and I'm gonna let you decide if you need to cut any of it out later.
Just don't go into too much detail.
It's kind of... Okay. So, at the beginning of this year, he was involved in an accident.
Car accident?
A car accident. How do you know?
The car accident that destroyed his car. No. And he lost his job at the same time.
Maybe. I don't know. It's, so, he was coming home New Year's morning from, I think, his girlfriend's house or a party or something. And there was this car that was, like, had gotten in a wreck. He saw no one was around. He couldn't tell if the guy had gotten out yet. So he pulls over.
So that's why you brought up a specific situation like that. Because I watched through it because I was curious.
I haven't seen the video, so I don't know what you're talking
about. He brings up exactly that situation. He's like, just do it. Because you never know, you're going to stop at a car accident, try to help the people, and then get involved in the accident yourself.
Okay, yeah, that's exactly what's going to happen in this story. So he pulls over, puts on his hazards, and gets out to go help the gentleman. Gets the guy out of the car. The guy has a big gash in his head, so he tries to get him away from the car. So right now he's between, like, Sean gets him over between where the crashed car was and Sean's car. They're, like, right here right now. An off-duty fireman comes, has also pulled over to help, and he comes over and helps the guy. So he asks Sean, can you please go get my cell phone out of my car? Well, the door that was closest to them at the moment would not open. It was smashed shut. So he went around to the other side of the car and was digging through from the passenger side. He couldn't find it, so he looks up. Next thing he sees is his own car in the air, tail first, heading towards him.
How?
Someone crashed into Sean's car. Someone wasn't paying attention. But that's the last thing Sean remembers. Now, the police report says that that man that Sean was helping did not make it. He was killed by the secondary crash. I don't know what happened to the firefighter. I assume he had gone back to his car to get medical supplies or something and then wasn't there. But Sean's car hit the first car that was in the accident, hit Sean, knocked Sean back about 30 feet, broke his thumb, got burns all down his arm, and he got a bad concussion from it. So, if Sean hadn't been looking for that phone, he would not have lived. If he had been on the other side of that car, he would not have lived.
So that's why he felt
that's,
he needed to do
this. That's why he's talking about that, like, because, like, any, like, if... That guy probably would not have made it, whether Sean's car was there or not, because he probably would have gotten hit head-on with another car when Sean's car wasn't there.
So if Sean didn't help, somebody else would have hit him regardless.
Yeah. But the thing is it was still, like, people were like, it's good that you tried to help him.
Well, yeah, it is good that he tried to help him.
Yeah.
And like, there's no ifs, ands, or buts.
Yeah, no, and honestly, all of us said I would have done the same thing.
Yeah.
Because people did that for me when I crashed the Mustang. They didn't know who I was. They saw a bad accident. They got out to make sure that no one was dead in the car. They wanted to make sure someone was still alive. And that's what happened to me, and that's how I was able to call someone. Because my phone was dead. I didn't have a charger with me. It's also part of why I always carry a charger and a battery pack with me now. So I never have a dead phone when I'm out. But, So I immediately, next time I see Sean, I make the joke straight to him. I'm like, dude, what the fuck is up with all of us being born in August and almost dying in car accidents? And he goes, I don't fucking know, dude. So, yeah, that's a thing. That happened. And I didn't know about that until fucking like 2 days ago. Apparently everyone else in our group knew that except for us. That's crazy.
Well, I don't talk to people because I'm bad at conversations.
That's true. But yeah, so, Sean, we love you, dude. We make fun of you a lot, because you're just our joke friend, but we do care about you, man. I'm looking at a picture of you on the screen from your video.
Faded black.
Yeah, it's faded to black, but we do care about you, man. Love you.
Because when I was watching this, I was like, what caused him to do this? Because you can see emotion in his face, mm-hmm. and he's like really feeling the situation, but it's just like...
Yeah, you didn't know the background yet.
What caused this? And then he goes into like specific detail of a story, and it's just like... Is this what happened?
Yeah, no, that.
But it's not like he doesn't go into too much detail. He just says accident helps.
Well, so I'm not going to go into other detail because those are details that have not been released yet. But the details that I basically went over have been released to the public. So anything else that I've been told has not been released yet and can't be mentioned. But that is what happened to our good friend Sean.
Man, what's shit happening to our friends? First, Chris's ex-bonnet. Lori's car getting towed.
Trixie's car getting towed.
Your Sean car is getting broken.
You getting a basically entirely new room. I just noticed the Razor sticker on there.
Yeah. Nice. When I got the headphones, I was just like, well, I have a new sticker. Here we go.
Pop. Smack. Still need to get a Cat Noir paw and put it on the side of it. That'd be good.
Yeah. It's funny because another thing I was thinking about that if I would have thought about it at the time instead of just Cat Noir, I was just like, I could have named it the Light Side. Lightsabers. Light Side.
Well, yeah, it's already named Cat Noir. Yeah. Like, you can't change it now. It's been cataloged in our videos.
Or the Skywalker, because Luke used the green saber, and when he did, he wore all black. So, Skywalker.
No, it's still Cat Noir.
Yeah, it's still Cat Noir, regardless, because that's just what it is.
Yeah, so that's some stuff that's been in the news. Jesus Christ, we've only been going for 26 minutes.
Feels like you say only, but this is like the best podcast so far that we've had in a while.
That's also true. But now's the part where I'm trying to remember more stories, and you already ran out of stories.
I mean, all I did all week was go out and buy stuff.
What did you buy?
Star Wars.
What kind of Star Wars?
I made my like little area Star Wars museum.
Pretty much. Like, there's... five Star Wars dolls over there. Sorry, I forget Yoda. Shorter than the others.
He's actually supposed to only be about knee high.
So that's actually too big for him.
He's about twice his height, yes.
Okay. There's two Bluetooth speakers that are different ships from the movies.
A TIE Fighter and the Millennium Falcon.
There's another mini Millennium Falcon directly under the Millennium Falcon.
Two more TIE Fighters. And the ship from Star Wars Rebels.
I like that ship. That one looks nice. Then what's over there?
Both BB-8 and R2 Spheros. Sphero being the manufacturer making the little, like, droid thing, so it connects to an app on my phone, and I can control them like they're RC cars.
Nice. Then you've also got your Diva Mech. I don't know if we've talked about that yet, but we got that last time I was over.
No, because then that would have been 2 weeks ago, and we didn't record two weeks ago.
That was when we did most of our recordings. It was two weeks ago. And then you've got two new helmets.
A clone, specifically Captain Rex, and then a Stormtrooper, just a shiny. That's all he is. He's just a shiny.
Yeah, and now he just put on the Storm.
These are not the droids I'm looking for.
That barely picks you up, dude. Like,
these are not the droids I'm looking for.
Yeah. These are not the droids you want.
These are not the droids I'm looking for.
How many times can we repeat?
We'll just repeat that for the next 10 minutes.
Okay. These are not the droids you were looking for.
Fuck you. Then we got the sabers hung up on the wall.
Yes.
The only new one being Kylo's.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That was funny because after we watched the new movie, there was a couple scenes where Kylo's sword gets thrown away and you see it laying on the ground. It was funny because after the movie was over and we came home, my dad and I were talking about the movie, and he mentioned to me how he kept looking at the saber, and he's like, man, I'm glad I got that for Tommy.
What?
I don't know. It was just funny to me.
That's just what he said?
Yeah.
Anyway. I'm trying to think. There's more stories from Furry Fiesta. Like, gotta fucking remember.
How you
like,
became a moonshine alcoholic?
Not a moonshine alcoholic. I just like the moonshine. Oh, yeah. No, that was Rowan. Rowan had that. Except his bottle was only 50, mine's 70. But he gave me some, and I was like, this shit's pretty fucking good.
Hey, that's pretty good.
Kind of thing. And then also one of our other friends had some apple cider. It was best apple cider I've had so far. It's pretty damn good. It was that one I sent you a picture of. I don't remember the name off the top of my head.
I don't know.
But yeah, so I had alcohol. And then, last night I bought the main set of Cards Against Humanity.
That was a game that we could have played.
What?
Or could play.
That is a game we could play. But we would also play against random people, so. We could definitely do it.
Would we have to censor it, though?
Nah.
I mean, well, yeah, it's just words. It's not like it's
It's not images. Like it's not like it's our opinions.
It's also not images. It's also it's true. It's just words.
So maybe that's a video we can do next. Is the Cards Against Humanity?
I was thinking about that when I saw the picture of you guys playing Cards Against Humanity. It made me remember the website. Yeah.
So, eventually I am going to own the full bigger, blacker box and have it full. And then we'll take it to, like, parties and stuff. And eventually we'll do an actual, like table flip-esque, like, we'll all be at a sitting at a table playing it. And we'll have a setup and everything, but that's down the line.
Why would I flip a table?
Because you lost. Motherfucker!
I don't get mad, though.
Yeah, you do.
Not like that.
Yeah, not like that, but you get mad. What else is there to talk about?
Then this? Again, who knows? I haven't really gotten mad since, you know...
The accident. I don't know. It just seems like something that you would say in that situation. He hasn't been the same since the accident.
I guess.
Yeah. So there was that story. That's I'm really trying to remember because I know there's more shit that was really funny to talk about.
Just me. You want to talk about J-Thor picture? Sleeping J-Thor?
Oh, no, I didn't really have anything to do with that. I just took the picture.
Yeah, I know, but so, you got to bring it up.
So, J-Thor...
I mean, look at the picture.
Friday...
We have to look at that picture. Well, we, you and I.
I mean, you can throw it up on... Like, you can click to throw it up on the thing if you want to.
Come over here, you asshole.
But, No, don't do it like that. Just, like, literally click the image thing and click send it to it. It'll be easier.
I don't have that picture downloaded.
Download it now while we're talking. But so J-Thor slept all fucking day Friday. He didn't wake up until 6 p.m. So he sleeps with one of those little eye masks on and earplugs in so that he can stay asleep. And here comes the picture.
Sometime right
about now. So that was J-Thor.
Wow. So this is
J-Thor. Yeah,
Here you go.
That is J-Thor. Someone, and I think it was Rowan, took some googly eyes and glued them to his mask while he was asleep.
Sure, he liked that when he woke up.
Oh no, it was funny because I was sitting next to him when he woke up, and he just like takes it off, sees it, and goes, and sets it down. So it was like the most like.
This is because of the fucking window capture.
Oh, okay. So, it was like the most nonchalant fucking reaction he could have had. It was pretty good. But yeah, that was a little story, I guess, the thing that happened in Jesus.
I just want to, like, get this ready for next time. Just in the middle of the podcast. Just in the middle of the
fucking... But put it small in the corner where it just, like, covers up your face or something. So next time we just click the button. Yeah. That's for next time we need it. Is it recording everything or just that?
Recording everything. Whatever you see on this screen is what it's recording.
Okay, fair enough.
So everybody saw me resizing it.
Okay, cool. So that was pretty funny. What else is there to talk? Fuck, there's not a lot to talk about when I wanted a lot to talk about. There were so many things that I wanted to say, and I was like, I'm gonna remember this. It's a good story. And I forgot all of it.
I wish there was more. Like, you would think, you seeing all the shit that's changed around here, that I'd have more stories.
Yeah, like, your house looks pretty fucking different, and I'm here pretty often.
But it's just, like, there wasn't really much that went on. I mean, my dad and I literally spent all day one day going between Best Buys just to find a fucking stormtrooper. Because he said he saw one at one of the Best Buys. Or not Best Buy, Big Lots.
Oh, okay.
He saw one at Big Lots. And I didn't believe him, because we went to, like, 7, and I didn't see a damn one.
That's how it was with my Zelda hat. Like, I saw one at a Target once when I didn't have money, and then when I had money, I could never fucking find it, I went from one to another to another.
But
another.
The thing is, since I didn't believe him, it no longer became a thing about wanting to get it from me.
It became a thing of proving him right.
Yes. So, we kept just going everywhere. Eventually, we went to Fry's, and sure enough, they had him. It's not the right one, it's not the same as them. But it still worked.
Which one?
Stormtrooper. The one on the far left. Like, Stormtrooper. Like,
What do you mean it's not the same?
Is that... It's not one of them. It's not that brand. This is something else brand.
Oh, okay.
Like, I think this is Hasbro, whereas there's some other, like, off-brand company.
Those ones aren't... Those look better than that one, though. Whatever. Anyways.
Well, that one talks and shit.
Oh, okay. So, he proved you wrong.
Yeah, eventually he found the First Order Stormtrooper at Walmart.
Okay.
Thus proving himself fully right.
Yeah. Okay. Nice. That's good.
And we've been trying to collect all of them, except for the ones that have faces, because I hate faces and toys.
So any masks?
Yeah.
Well, what about Yoda? Yoda has a face.
Well, Yoda's also, like, this tall. So...
He's a little gremlin.
So it was just like, fuck yeah, Yoda.
He's a 900-year-old gremlin.
I mean, you also have his walking stick over here, but I couldn't fit it into his fucking hand.
I did notice that sitting there.
Also, you wonder how much these little tiny figures here cost?
Too much?
$3 a piece.
Why?
I don't know. I saw them in one of them. Most of it, I wanted one of the fucking gunships, the clone dropships.
Okay.
Hold on. I want to pull it up. Fuck, I can't fucking hit L.
Type.
One of these.
Oh, okay.
Gonna open image, new tab.
Plop it in right there.
I wanted to find, because there was one of them in one of the packs, and I kept feeling them out, and trying to figure out, all right, this might be one.
Oh, they were like blind packs.
Yeah.
Okay.
This might be one, or this one might be one, and I'm trying to figure out which one might be it. And I kept feeling this one, and it felt like it, because I thought this was the wings. Because they had, a thing on the bottom, and I thought this was the top of these wings.
Oh, okay. Well, he's holding a TIE fighter.
And we went out to the van, and I start opening them up. I open them all up. And by the time I'd gotten this TIE fighter, the smallest one, I already had all of those. And I'm just like, son of a bitch, another fucking TIE fighter. I don't need another one.
That's funny. You have too many TIE fighters. Ha ha. So is the one with the red on it specifically a certain person's?
The red ones are the First Order.
Oh, okay.
So it's that one's. But the ones that are lighter, like the one in the back by Pikachu, is the older ones. The ones that came around with Vader.
Oh, okay. What about this one that doesn't have the red on it, but it's still black?
That's still one of them.
Oh, okay.
Like, they would have red on it. I think the red ones would be, commanders or something. I mean, I might be wrong. Podcast is recording. People are hearing it. And I'm sure somebody somewhere might correct me someday.
In the comments below, please.
But I'm going to assume that red means it's, a commander ship. So, but yeah. Too many TIE fighters.
Yeah, no, you've got, six now.
When I just wanted the one. But that, the...
You didn't even want that until we found it, and you were like, oh, okay, cool.
No, I remember we were sitting here, and we were talking about getting the Millennium Falcon. I was just like, wouldn't it be cooler if I got a TIE fighter instead? And then we went to the Toys R Us, and sure enough, they fucking had that. So I was just like, all right, cool.
Oh, yeah.
Also, we didn't only just go to every Big Lots within, 100-mile radius. We went to every JCPenney in a 100-mile radius. And... We went to just about every Walmart trying to find BB-8.
Really?
BB-8 was with the Walmarts. JCPenney was because we were getting discounts on clothes.
Okay.
And Big Lots was because we were trying to find a fucking Stormtrooper.
Wait, the BB-8 was at the Toys R Us, though. Why would you be checking Walmart?
We went to Toys R Us. We went to Walmart. We went to Fry's. We went to Best Buy. We went everywhere. We could not fucking find this little bastard.
Why don't you just...
Because my dad was just like, we don't want to wait for it.
Oh, okay.
And then we finally found it out at Walmart. It was the last one they had. And I'm just like, son of a bitch. I was just about to give up. And the fucked up part is, after we bought it, he's just like, yeah, I was going to get R2 if they had one. And, a day later, he buys R2 online. And R2 comes in, I'm like, R2 is way fucking cooler than BB-8.
Well, the BB-8, before you actually play with it and you just see it, you're like, oh, no, BB-8's got to be cooler, right?
Yeah.
Because it's a ball that actually is a ball, but it's just a magnet.
Yeah, the thing that's boring about it is R2 lights up, makes noise,
and like is R2.
Falls. He falls.
Like, he does shit. And then BB-8's just a fucking ball with a thing that's stuck to it. No noise, no lights. What you see is what you get. And, like...
But at least BB-8 has a little training pad so you can actually drive him around without crashing into shit.
Yeah. I mean, it's fun. It's cool. But R2's so much cooler. Like, I'm sorry, but Sphero's, like, my favorite one is definitely the R2 units. So R2 or whatever the black one is. I can't remember what the fuck it's called. The
black and gold one?
The black and copper one.
Oh, copper. It's probably what I'm thinking of.
It's... I don't remember what it's called. Sphero R2. Not R2-D2. It's like R2 something or R4 something.
Then type in R4.
I don't fucking remember. I don't know if that's actually the number. Probably wrong. You'll help me find it. You, help me find it.
Nope.
Nope.
Just go on Sphero.
No, go away.
Just type in Star Wars up at the top.
You motherfucker. R2-Q5.
I don't know. Oh, okay. So, yeah, that's what I was thinking of, yeah. That's a Best Buy exclusive. You had to go to every Best Buy.
Oh, no, we saw a bunch of these and the other... black one. I didn't want this one because in the new movie, that thing's an asshole.
Why would you not want it then?
It's a dick.
Wait, there's BB-8, BB-9,
R2-Q5.
Yeah.
And, you know, we got the better two, the more iconic two.
That's true.
I have no idea where this one came from.
The Force Band is sold separately?
Yeah. It's literally so you can push and pull and, like, pretend you have the Force. I was just like, you know, if I play with it, I'm going to have it on my left wrist. I'm going to hold my lightsaber in my right hand and just be like, whoosh, whoosh, bop.
Does it work well?
I think it only works with BB-8.
Oh, okay.
But literally you have to, like, fling your arm to get it to actually, like, move him. Like, you know, push forward, pull back, push left, push right, and then push down to stop them. And it's just like, oh my god, this is just annoying. I'd rather just use my phone. Like, if it was, like, smooth, where I could, like, go, like, smoothly push my arm left and right.
Well, it's got a sense of sudden jerk in the little dude for it to do that. It's probably what it is.
So, if it was, like, smoother, then yeah, I'd have fun with it. But since you're literally having to throw your arm... It's just really fucking annoying.
Okay. I'll play with it later. See how it works.
But yeah.
BB-8 is so much smaller than R2. Looking at them.
BB-8's like, smaller than R2.
Yeah. Yoda's smaller than them, but look at this size comparison on your shelf.
It's from the movie.
Set the BB-8 down in front of him. Like at that angle. Oh yeah, that's about the right size. Actually, the BB-8 should be a tiny bit bigger.
Well, if R2's leg was out.
Oh yeah, do that real quick.
I'd have to turn it on.
Yeah, turn him on. Live on the podcast, we're gonna turn on R2-D2.
Yes, in that way. Here, R2, let me jerk you off.
Where would his winger be?
I don't know, probably in here.
Is that what that little capsule is? Point to it on. Oh, no, you don't have the screen.
That doesn't need to be on for R2. Fucking BB-8 it does. BB-8 doesn't have a speaker, so you have to have it play through your phone.
Nice.
R2. R2 has a speaker. R2's my little buddy now. Like, literally, I've had him sit here with my app open just so he keeps, like, turning and like doing stuff.
That's funny.
Cause it's really cool just to see him like interact with the world.
It'd be really cool if he actually interacted with stuff around you, like bumps into stuff, scoots it around on purpose.
Well, I don't think he has that kind of programming.
I know, but if he
like I said, I can set him on the floor and set him to like autonomously just roll around, and he literally rolls around, looks at stuff. BB-8 does the same thing, and if BB-8 runs into something, he'll literally stop, and you'll see his head come back, and he'll look up at it like, what the fuck?
I kind of want to see that now. We'll have to play with those later whenever we get done.
Like, that's one of my favorite things that he does, because it's literally, you'll hear. And then it's just like, you see his little head come back, and he's like,
the fuck?
And then, like I showed you, you grab him by the head, and his little ball starts spinning. It's like, fucker, put me down. Put me the fuck down. I'll kick your ass. Fight me. I will fucking end you. It's like, oh, shit. Little ball droid's got some, like,
dick in him.
Which one was it that we wanted to do?
We just wanted to get his leg out.
All right. So we could go. You little bitch! I know you're sassy in the movies and all, you little fucker, but... Okay, don't sass me. Right, I'm gonna do this.
Yeah, no, BB-8 needs to be bigger.
Huh? Because look, BB-8's height's with the vent. Height's with the vent.
You're right. I guess they did put it to scale. Good on them.
You want to know how much it is to get a full-scale R2 that moves around?
How much?
$7,500.
You're gonna buy that
someday. No, hell no.
You're gonna someday. Like, when you have money, you're gonna be like, this has been my dream. Just like you're gonna get one of your kids that Land Rover or whatever it was. Speed Runner. That's
what that thing's only like $100, though.
Oh, there's a green light in the back.
Yeah.
I'm having fun playing with R2 now. Which one is this one? Oh, he farted. Okay.
Oh, I was wrong. They're $500. Oops.
Oh, the little land speeder?
Yeah.
Yeah, that little land speeder's fucking cool. Don't you agree, R2? Yeah.
Was that from you picking up? Yeah.
Okay.
He has human interaction.
That is cool as shit, dude.
Just like if I could figure it out, he will talk to BB-8. Like, they'll sit there and actually interact.
Really?
They can't figure it out. Also, this is probably really loud on the microphone. Not the head turning, but when he starts beeping.
It's about the same volume as us.
Anytime you start trying to move his wheels, that's why I keep picking him up, because I don't want him to fall. Like I was saying earlier to Soldier. This is like a rich man's toy, and I'm a poor man. The $120 toy
that I have. It's not a toy. It's a collectible.
I'd rather, you know, take care of it and not have it fucking fall off my desk and break. Really?
I didn't know what that one did. I think it's fun. Which one's the one that made him fall over? Okay, he's looking at you now. What is this one? What does this one do?
It doesn't do anything.
Well, it's a button, so I want to know what it does.
Those are different settings to put him into.
His internal temperature is...
Yeah, because that's for autonomous mode.
I don't know what that means.
And it'll drive himself.
Oh, okay. Well, then I'll just leave him like that.
Yeah, but he's not going to drive himself until you hit the fucking play button, see?
Okay, well, we're going to have to let you guys go for this podcast. Thank you for joining us. I've got to take a call with Thomas's dad.